My name is Ludwing Salamanca. I am a psychiatrist. I work in primary care clinics, helping identify and address the mental needs of patients and families to make sure they're getting comprehensive care. So some of the things that we're going to talk about today are really understanding the perspective of the parents when they are hesitant about a vaccine or rejecting a vaccine, trying to walk in their shoes and understand from their viewpoint what are some of those concerning things that are holding them back and making it difficult for them to understand the importance of the vaccine or decide that a vaccine is what their kids should be getting. And other things we're going to talk about is how to communicate with them and really tackle that hesitation and really work in a collaborative way with them so we can move forward past that hesitation and increase vaccination rates. I grew up in Colombia. Initially, I was planning to study something else, but then one of my family members had a medical issue and I got very involved in the whole care she was receiving. I did medical school in Colombia, and in Colombia it's impossible not to get involved to a certain degree with all the social injustices and all the social chaos that happens in the country. And during my medical school, I really wanted to get involved in many different public health projects to try to address some of those needs that the population had. I then decided to come to the United States to complete training in psychiatry and also complete a PhD in public health. Communicating is very important because we have the science, we have the evidence, we have the treatments, right? But the end user of all those treatments are going to be our patients. And if they don't understand the condition, if they don't understand the need for a treatment or an intervention, they're not going to engage. So that's why it's so important for them to really understand what's going on with their health and what are some potential options they have to address those needs. And definitely we need to work with them in a partnership so we provide the information, the education, and then we think together what are going to be the best treatment strategies for them based on their preferences, their values, and their understanding of what's happening. It's very important to be able to communicate effectively with parents, especially regarding vaccination, because we know that we have many interventions that are going to be helpful in preventing multiple illnesses. However, if we're not being effective and clear when we talk to parents, since they are the ones that are going to be at the end deciding if their kids are going to get the vaccine or not, we will unfortunately not see a very big uptake of vaccination. That's why it's so key for us to really communicate clearly and in a very mindful and effective way when we talk to parents about this. Okay, so before we get started, let's make sure we're all on the same page with some definitions. Health equity is the attainment of the highest level of health for all people. Health equity means efforts to ensure that all individuals have fair and just opportunities to be as healthy as possible, removing obstacles such as poverty, discrimination, and their consequences. Social determinants of health, or non-medical drivers of health outcomes, can play a big role in vaccine hesitation. Many times poverty, lack of education, or lack of access to reliable sources of information are going to play a huge role in how patients and parents are having these conversations and understanding vaccinations. When we think about health equity, we're thinking about a way of increasing the chances of everyone in the community, regardless of those social determinants of health, to have a positive outcome in terms of their health, and also increasing access to everyone. Cultural competence is the ability of healthcare providers and organizations to understand and effectively respond to the cultural and linguistic needs of patients from diverse backgrounds. When we think about diversity, we think about multiple different variables and characteristics that makes us who we are. If we really want to provide culturally sensitive care, we need to bring those concepts and those ideas to the office with us. And we really need to understand and try to make sure that in the care we are providing, we're helping people understand care, engage with care, and really work with the team based on their preferences, their understanding of the conditions, their background, and all those variable characteristics that we conceptualize as diversity. Cultural humility, it's our ability to recognize all those preconceived notions we have about our patients, the communities, families we're working with, being able to self-reflect, identify those perceived biases, and address them so we can work more effectively with patients and families. Health literacy. That's our parents or patient understanding of a medical condition, potential treatments to address that, and potential outcomes that can come after they engage in a particular treatment. Motivation and interviewing. It's an approach that helps us understand the reasons why patients are struggling to change our behavior. It's going to help us work with them in a collaborative way so we understand the reasons why they're hesitant, but also their own motivations to vaccinate their kids and engage in healthier behaviors as a family. An example of a patient that will benefit from motivational interviewing. Let's call her Anna. She recently moved to the city and she has two kids. She always wants to do the best for her kids, but she has been very concerned about vaccination because she sees a lot of information in social media about potential negative side effects of vaccinations. So she came to the office and she was really, really hesitant about vaccinating her kids. And we had the opportunity to talk to her and really understand the reasons why she was so hesitant and what was driving that high anxiety and that reluctance to vaccinate her kids. Some of her concerns were long-term consequences of vaccines. By asking open-ended questions, but really trying to understand her perspective and really wanting to provide the information that was relevant and valuable to her, were able to be successful because those concerns were really getting in her way of deciding and vaccinating her kids. And that's the beauty of motivational interviewing and other communication styles that consider this a collaboration and definitely a two-way, a bi-directional avenue that help us as provider provide the information and the knowledge that patients need to make a decision. Okay, so let's talk about health literacy. Vaccination is a very good example of this. When Anna first came to the clinic, the team assumed that she had very good health literacy about vaccines. But by asking questions and really understanding her perspective, we realized that there were a lot of missing pieces in the information she had. There was a lot of information that was not accurate, and many of her fears were coming from posts on social media that were not verified or not rigorous in what they were claiming. We should be mindful that many of those concerns are valid, even if they are not based on true evidence and true science. Just by the fact that the parent is concerned about those things makes that anxiety valid. What we did was what we call elicit, provide, elicit. It's a very simple technique that can help us understand the reason why Anna was hesitant, provide some information, and then going back to her. So we initially asked some questions, right? Why are you hesitant about vaccinations? Why are you fears about this? Where have you been getting the information about this? Once she was able to tell us and share with us her concerns, we were able to provide information that was evidence-based and relevant to the concerns she had. After doing that, we asked her, after reviewing this information and after learning these facts, what do you think about vaccinating your kids today? And that's where she decided to go ahead and vaccinate them. So you really need to use very clear language when you're communicating with a parent. Many times we have many different ways of understanding information and learning. Some of us learn and understand by just hearing, others by seeing things, and others by reflecting what we just heard. So we need to be mindful of that and use different ways of communicating with our patients. Many times visual aids can be of great help. Sometimes even videos that you can quickly watch online can be helpful. Asking them to repeat the information is very helpful. And making sure that whenever you're communicating with them, you're using clear and simple language that they will be able to understand. when we're having an honest conversation with parents about vaccinations and the reasons why they're hesitant, it's very important to acknowledge that there are some potential risks. And part of the process is helping them understand the risks and the benefits and do a balance. And we know that the benefits far outweigh the risks of vaccinating. Cultural humility is very important because by using that framework, we'll be able to understand multiple characteristics and variables that can be impacting a family's way of interacting with the healthcare system, understanding a disease, understanding a treatment, or what to expect from a treatment. Many times as providers, if we are not aware of our own perceived biases, and if we really don't incorporate cultural humility in what we do, we will struggle to connect with parents and families and really understand their needs, their concerns, and what they really need to know to be able to make this type of decisions. Some of the techniques that we can use to engage with parents in a way that addresses our own perceived biases and perceptions about families is getting to know them, getting to understand who they are culturally, ethnically, what's important to them, what they value, what are some of their fears, are there any religious aspects playing a role in their decision, is it something that other members of the community are doing, what are those concerns, what are those things that others are saying, some of the reasons why they are hesitant to vaccinate their kids. If they realize that you are concerned about them as human beings and really want to engage with them, then the success of your interventions is gonna be way higher. So using these different techniques are gonna help the medical team build trust because families are gonna see that the team cares about them, cares about their concerns, the questions they have, and really want to work with them in a collaborative way to be able to provide the treatments and get better outcomes. The same way we have preconceived notions and biases towards our patients, they're going to have preconceived biases and notions about us as providers. So being able to recognize that will really help both parts of in the equation being honest and transparent when they are communicating. Going back to Honest Cass, we assumed she knew what vaccines were, the importance of vaccinating her kids, and if we're not mindful of that, we're just going to continue emphasizing the message without really understanding the reasons why she was hesitant and really being able to tailor our education and our approach to her particular needs. So we really need to understand their point of view, understand them in a more comprehensive way to then be able to have this open conversation, address their particular needs and questions, and therefore be able to move forward with vaccination. So in conclusion, to be able to work more effectively with parents, we really need to understand the reasons why they're hesitant about vaccinating their kids. In order to do so, we need to ask open-ended questions that will help us understand their point of view and their concerns. Once we have identified those, we're going to provide targeted education so they can get correct information and be able to make decisions based on that risk and benefit analysis. And hopefully we'll be able to encourage them to go ahead and vaccinate their kids. Thank you so much for joining us today, and we really hope that moving forward, you can start utilizing many of those techniques to be more effective when you communicate with parents.